This is our group. Our task is to find evidence of design thinking in Plus Studio. But first, let's take a look at what's design thinking. Think of your brain. Your brain is made up of a left side and a right side. The left side of your brain uses analytical thinking. This is considered quantitative and very reliable. It makes sense of things such as that 1 plus 1 equals 2. In other words, it functions with learned theory. The right side of your brain uses intuitive thinking. It's where your creativity emerges. Unfortunately, the left side of your brain has been getting way too much attention, for example in business. Many things have been said of the right side of the brain. It's been labeled as pure feeling and intuition, hard to measure and therefore risky in business, more apt for design and the arts. Now, the world has become very complex, and therefore the traditional tools for problem solving are not enough. The full potential of your brain is needed, right and left. One might say that by using both sides of the brain, you become a design thinker. Let's have a look at this in practice. Now here's Sally. Sally loves to cook. She has recipes which give her all the needed ingredients, amounts, and guide her through the cooking step by step. Now, this is pretty great if you don't mind eating the same thing and you want to play it safe. Now, let's call that left side of the brain cooking. Now, Sally's little sister is Lisa. Lisa hates recipes, but just like Sally, she loves to cook. As written recipes aren't an option for Lisa, she simply improvises. She looks in the fridge and goes with her instinct when deciding what to cook. Despite her creativity and good intentions, the food sometimes makes Lisa sick. Now one day, Sally and Lisa decide to cook together. They combine their ways of thinking to improve upon Sally's recipes with a touch of Lisa's imagination. The new dishes turn out to be wonderful. In practice, design thinking would mean combining traditional business tools, such as benchmarking and forecasting, with organic tools, such as intuition and feelings. A design thinker would look at a company from a universal perspective, the so-called 4D model. This combines both sides of the brain, including intuition, feeling, thinking, and sensing. Let's start with zero dimension. This is the purpose of the company. It defines its mission, why it exists. Next, we move on to the first dimension. This is the philosophy of the company, the values by which it runs. The next stop is the second dimension. This is the platform and process of the company. It clarifies the competitive advantage the company holds. The third dimension. This is the actual product or service. It's the attributes we can sense. The fourth dimension represents time over which the company improves and reinvents itself. Design thinking is both mindset and methodology. It responds to why, who, how, and what a company stands for. Plus Studio is a co-working space in the heart of Helsinki's design district. It serves as a platform for creative minds who share values in design and collaboration. Plus Studio aims to create synergies among people working in the same space. It's targeted to those who want to understand the way design transforms business by adding value to product innovations and branding. On a regular day, people at Plus Studio have breakfast together and present and comment on projects during different events. The space is presented as a creative, multidisciplinary community with a touch of serious business.
The breakfasts, that it's a really nice way to start your mornings, like to talk about some topic that's in the air at the moment, and then sort of get new ideas from people, and it's just like a relaxed day, like relaxed way to start your day.
So, is there evidence of design thinking in Plus Studio? As part of our design thinking assignment, we met up with Plus Studio founder Sami Oinonen, who had this to say.
No, yeah. I mean, design thinking, you know, it's I don't even actively use that term. I rather use, you know, service design, for example. But to me, more important is that it's not to frame something under an umbrella. and claim it that, you know, it's something. For me, it's just that we develop products and services, and it's just a common sense that we develop nowadays and actually always with the other end users and the people who are actually using the other services. It's just a common sense. That's the way you need to do it. Because the one thing I learned, you know, at Nokia is that, you know, assumption is a mother of all fuck-ups. So I mean, do not assume. Just, you know, it's so easy to discuss with people because they are here. And you test the other ideas and involve and start co-designing and co-creating. So if co-design and co-creating is design thinking, then fine. I'm happy and good, you know, have a t-shirt label that I'm a design thinker or something.
We believe that Plus Studio's mission and values display a basic understanding of design thinking. They use their business knowledge in an open and collaborative way to amplify the benefits of interaction among its members. These values are evident in some of Plus Studio's practices, such as open plan spaces for work and multiple design events throughout the year for their member companies to showcase their work. If we look a bit deeper, some of the company's activities respond to trials by management aimed at creating a culture of design and continuous experimentation at the premises. The founders constantly prototype new ideas to see how these may improve the work of all involved. If these fail, they're modified and new ones take their place. Feedback is collected from customer companies throughout. Sami Oinonen sees his role as that of a curator among the community. Is this design thinking or just a buzzword though? We prompted Sami for a response, and here's what he had to say.
I'd like to call myself as a curator, because that sounds so cool on a title level. It's even better than like a CEO or the evangelist or something like that. But, so I consider that, you know, I provide a certain platform being the space and the services, and my job really is to nudge people that they meet the other people they wouldn't otherwise meet. So I'm kind of a curator, a social glue, if you will.
But how about the future? How to continue harnessing design thinking to develop Plus Studio further? As a team, we looked at the main parts of Plus Studio's business, those important to the future. We looked at aspects such as the premises, partnerships, revenue, and who their customers are, as well as Plus Studio's communications. We thought long and hard and decided to create a roadmap of where this thinking might take Plus Studio in the coming years. Now, the task was simple. People in the team suggested an area they would like to look at, and then we chipped in ideas on each one. Should we think of soundproofing for the facilities? Can the spatial design be improved, perhaps? Surely a daycare for children would help members stress less, right? Should we create an urban garden? What's that, some thought? Could the kitchen play a central role in the community? The service had to go international, we thought, but how to make the most of multiple locations? How could we make getting into Plus Studio both highly desirable and ensure that people get not just office space, but also a guarantee that they will truly develop? Let's choose the best and most passionate to join the service, we thought, and also provide training opportunities that are not easily available elsewhere. The ideas were many, and yet we thought none of them truly captured the value that Plus Studio wants to provide. None of them were just big enough. How about a truly big idea that it could incorporate all of the above? We set some ground rules for this though. First, the new Plus Studio must make use of what already exists and make it the center of a growing ecosystem by adding young talent and corporate support. Second, Plus Studio's renewed focus must first make use of stakeholders that are already within the community and empower them to build a vision. Third, being a part of Plus Studio in the future has to provide more benefits than just office space and networking. Selecting the best to join and ensuring their skills are developed even further means that everybody will learn to grow. So, we began to picture Plus Studio as a rich ecosystem of entrepreneurs, coaches, large companies, and young talents. Yes, that means students. Consensus was that the co-working space and collaboration culture has to remain at the core of the community. We envisioned this as the perfect environment to foster a culture that teaches up-to-date industry trends through hands-on projects. How about tapping into corporate funding, we thought. After all, companies will be able to obtain ready-made professionals with an international mind and skilled in the industry's latest trends, something that larger academic institutions don't find so easy to do. Finally, how can we ensure that this new training aspect of Plus Studio can gain the reputation and notoriety that it needs? Strategic partnerships with well-established players around the globe came into the picture, and our main benchmark was Swedish initiative Hyper Island. Remember our interview with Sami Oinonen? Well, here's what we hope it will sound like 10 years from now.
Hello everyone. Thank you very much for being with us for a long while. I'm in the sauna. It's a really nice sauna, having a beer here, but the point is really that I want to clarify to you shortly the concept of Plus Studio that we've been discussing here. So it's a co-working community for people who want to shape the future. Plus Studio is also a network stretching from the Nordic countries through Amsterdam and Berlin all the way to St. Petersburg. The Plus Studio community consists of people who are working in the space as members. So we're talking about startups and freelancers, for instance, like creative people. Working in a space that's all about encouraging co-creation and feedback, Plus Studio is the ideal working spot for people who really, really follow their passion, right? Now, on the other hand, the current education system kills creativity, and really it prepares students for kind of enduring their professional life instead of pursuing their passion. Therefore, Plus Studio also operates a school. Now, the school is called the Plus School, and it offers an education like no other. In this school, students are learning by doing. So instead of theory-focused education, Plus School is built around real-life projects from Plus Studio members and other leading industry players. So no books and no exams. Cheers. In Plus School, students learn from each other and directly from leading experts. With Plus School, companies get the professionals they need immediately, so you don't have to pick someone up, train them for 6 months and hope it's all gonna turn out well. So, in the Plus Studio community, the members get fresh ideas and top talent. On the other hand, students get work on real needs, real clients, real companies, from startups to large corporations. The collaboration embraces future trends and technologies. So once again, thank you very much and have a good one.